Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to another awesome tutorial in the Christmas calendar tutorial series. And in this one, we are going to talk about Sherlock. Give your iOS simulator superpowers. So let's start. Okay, now Sherlock is a macOS app, and indeed it gives your iOS simulator superpowers. Go ahead and click the link down below for the resources and the links and everything that you need to get for this tutorial. And you can go to sherlock.inspiredcode.io and take a look at this awesome app. Of course, this is only in beta, but you can download the beta version, and I already did, and they are coming up with new versions weekly, so the production is awesome. Now, what is this Sherlock? Why is it giving our iOS simulator superpowers, and how does it give superpowers? Well, in the previous two videos, as I was going through the code and creating the YouTube UI with the help of tiny constraints, we had a lot of tweaking and build and running and waiting for the simulator to start up and taking a look at the example screenshot that I took and making sure that the simulator, roughly stays the same as looks the same as the screenshot. Well, with Sherlock, you can edit views and layout constraints in real time, so you get the chance to edit your views in the simulator. So let me just jump right in and show you how it looks like. So let me minimize this, and here is my project. You could use this project from my GitHub repository, or you could just launch any of your projects that has some views in it. After you download it, Sherlock, go ahead and install it. And once you open up an Xcode project, you will see this icon, and it says can't see your app. Now that is because we aren't running our app in the simulator just yet. So let me just build and run that. Okay, here we go. It is a building. And this is my so-called final project, but we still need to have a lot of tweaking to do here, as you can imagine. And we can do that with the help of Sherlock. So let's click on the icon, and as you can see, the automatically our project has been detected in the simulator. And here we have an activate inspector. So let's click on that, and now you can go ahead and take a look at your simulator, but let's just click on this UI image view, and it is a UI view. And this little window will pop up, and it's so awesome because let's say you want to set this to, basically, you can change the views properties, the layer properties, the alignment, and so on. And I will go deep into this in this video. Okay, let me just scroll down. And of course, if for some reason jump to file in this project doesn't work, but you can just simply jump to the file of your Xcode project. And again, this is in beta, so no worries if something doesn't work. It's still in beta, but once it will be released, it will be awesome. So let me just go to this layer, and here we have our corner radius. So let's set this corner radius, let's say, to 8. There you go. As you can see, we have rendered the image out in our simulator. So now let us just take a look at what can we edit further. So here we have our views, we have our labels, and here you can set the constraints and so on. And here you have your view hierarchy. So let me just select this one and let's go and maybe set the height to be equal to, let's say 300, when it's a bit too large, 250. Okay, 150. Okay, and as you can see here, it is, I don't really know that if you can see because it's red and the image is red too, but here it is. So let's take this to 20. It's much better, 220. Okay, what is up next? Let's say to the right, minus 16. So let's make this 50 so you may see that, or rather yet 150. Okay, so you can see that the image is actually moving. Okay, let's get back that to 60. Okay, and of course you can take a look at the labels too. And let's see, we are not going to anchor this. Let's take a look at the text here. So let's go back to our view and I want to delete this Rebel developer. So there we go, we have deleted that. And maybe some color, let's add our to be red color. Great, awesome. So now you know that how it will look like. And as of today, I have a lot more subscribers. So let's add in here 62 subscribers. Great. Okay, maybe I want to make this a little bit bigger. Let's see, where is, it's in the layer, I believe. Yeah, you cannot change the bounds of this one. Okay, it is a work in progress, but it is so awesome that you can change all of these in the simulator and see your changes live. Okay. One last thing I want to show you. Let me just close this and let's see. Here we have resizable screen. Select your simulator and your resizable screen. And as you can see, it renders out the screen. I am here in an iPhone X 10R and here I can render this out in an iPhone 5 simulator, and you can already see that we do have some problems here. But let's go and select iPhone 6, much better, 6 plus, great. Okay, and iPhone 10 and 10S Max. Okay, now you can see your rendered out views side by side, and iPhone, iPad is on its, well, I believe iPad already is supported, but this is not an iPad version of the simulator, so that won't be included in here. Go ahead and take a look at the iPhone version for yourself. Now, again, take a look at Sherlock for iOS from InspiredCode. This is not at all a sponsored video. I just really like it and I use it a lot to tweak some things on my code. So go ahead and check it out and try it out for yourself. Now that is it for me today. Go ahead, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and leave me a comment down below in the comment section. What do you think about Sherlock? Do you like it? Do you think that this is an awesome beta version? And are you going to use Sherlock in the future? And as always, I will see you in the next one.